Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to make this glowing 3D text that you see on the screen right now. I want to note that I have to use this on-screen keyboard because I'm paralyzed and I cannot use my hands and arms, so it will be in the way from time to time. And we'll set up an edit page. As usual, right click in the media pool, new fusion composition. You can name it if you'd like, but you don't have to. And go ahead and leave it on 5 seconds. Bring it down to your timeline and go to fusion. We'll start out with a 3D text node, a 3D render, select the text node and put the text you're liking in. If your text is too high like mine, select the center V anchor. That'll line it up. Go ahead and set your tracking, size and everything now. With the text node still selected, we'll grab a merge. We'll bring a spotlight down, but we won't connect it yet. Select the render node. Enable lighting and shadows. Now you see we have no light. I go to render type and go to hardware render. That'll make it render out faster. Let's connect the spotlight to the merge now. And put that merge into viewer 1. And go to the inspector and open the cone all the way. I'm going to change the light intensity to 0.8. Seems to be about the best for this, but set it to your liking. And with the spotlight still selected, go to transform. Use target. Under translation, Z-axis. We'll set that value to 10. And we just move the light back away from the text. Should have showed you in case you don't know. There it is again. And we'll go back to 10. Let's grab a background. We want to connect that to the text node. As you can see, there's no way of doing it. So we're going to do a few things with the text node selected. Let's add some excursion to it. I'm going to go ahead and turn the excursion all the way up. Basically, for the sake of the tutorial, you can set yours to whatever you'd like. Take the excursion subdivisions all the way up to the right. And smoothing angle. I'm going to set my bevel depth and width at 0.0063. But again, this is a personal preference thing. Okay, back to the issue of the background node having no input connection on the text. Go over to shading and select image. Now you'll see there's another input we can connect to. Then select the background node. Under type, we'll change it to gradient. And if you look at the text, it is on character. Let's go ahead and bring these lines in a little bit. Okay, now back to the character. Select the text node again. Under mapping level, change from character to word. Now the gradient will be across the whole word, not each individual character. Now select the render, shift spacebar, and aperture diffraction. You'll see now we don't have an alpha channel. It's not transparent. So come up here and select this, and we have our transparency back. Take the aperture size all the way up. Before we mess around with these controls anymore, let's go back to the background, add some color. You click on these little arrows. It's already black, so we don't have to do that on this one. This one we'll click on. Now we change the color. Under layout, you can rotate it right here if you'd like. I would like to mention, this seems to work best on a picture or a video like I have on a timeline, a night scene with a lot of lights, for whatever reason. It looks pretty good. Okay, under the aperture diffraction node, I'm going to right click on rotation, modify width, and on curve. Now if you scrub the timeline, you can see the glow is rotating. I want to speed mine up a little bit. So go to the modifier up here that we just made. Go down here to scale. I'm going to change the 180 to 540. Let's check it, make sure it looks good. Okay, we'll go ahead and make the macro now. If you want this intensity here, just turn the spotlight down some. It was too bright. Go back to the background node. And select ping pong. Okay, now we'll do the macro. Select them in the order that I do. The first one I select will be at the top of the inspector. The last one will be at the bottom. Make sure nothing's selected and hold down the control button on Windows. I think it's Option on Mac. And hit A. Make sure the control button's still down. Deselect the media out. We do not want that. Right click on any one of the other nodes. Go to Macro. Create macro. Give it a name. And follow along. background. For the gradient, or the four corner, we have to select all these all the way down. Atom curves. Select scale. And change scale to rotation. Spotlight, put light in front of X, select intensity and put light in front of intensity. Select the aperture. We do not want rotation because we have that animated with Adam's curves. Go create a file, save as group, it takes you to macros, go to Fusion instead, templates, edit, titles, here's where you can make a folder, if you need to, I already have one made. And save. Close out your macro. If you click on it, look in the inspector. You have all the controls we selected in macro. There's no reason to be spending much time on this. You can go ahead and play around with all the controls, see what they do. Render the cache. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.